We have to start with the types of connective tissue. So there are three basic types of connective tissue proper. There are three types of connective tissue, that is connective tissue proper, fluid connective tissue and supportive connective tissue. So today we will discuss about the types of different types of connective tissue proper. Okay. So connective tissue proper, CT stands here for connective tissue, so don't get confused. So types of connective tissue proper. So there are three types of connective tissue proper. Before starting with the types of connective tissue, we must know why this tissue is known as connective tissue proper. Because this tissue is found throughout our body. Like proper noun, common noun, collective noun you have studied. So proper, it means everywhere. So this connective tissue, which is found everywhere in our body, is known as connective tissue proper, or found throughout our body. And the basic function of connective tissue proper is that it acts as a packaging substance, and also it helps in the binding of the organs with the other organs. There are three types of connective tissue proper, that is areolar connective tissue, adipose connective tissue and fibrous connective tissue. Okay, then first we have to start with the areolar connective tissue. This connective tissue will fill the spaces between the organs and connects our skin to the underlying muscles. So these two are the basic location. What are the basic location? It fills up the spaces between the organs. For example, stomach is there, liver is there. Okay, so this space will be filled by a tissue, and this space will be filled by a tissue, and this tissue is known as what? Areolar tissue. It also binds the skin. This is your skin and here is the muscle. So a tissue is there which is binding the skin with the muscle is areolar connective tissue. And as this areolar connective tissue is elastic in nature, so that is why when you pull up or stretch up the skin, you are able to withstand the pulling strain, because this areolar tissue is elastic in nature, or this areolar tissue has elastic fibers in its matrix. Okay, so this is the structure of areolar connective tissue. You have seen here elastic fibers, so that is why we are able to bear the pulling strain on the skin. Macrophages are actually the type of WBC. Collagen fibers is there. So what you are observing, minimum cells are there and maximum intercellular space is there. Okay, and this space is filled with the fibers, and these are the adipocyte cells. In the next type of connective tissue proper, that is the adipose tissue, we will see that adipose tissue is made up of special cells known as adipocytes, which is functioning to store the fat in it. And this is the plasma cell. Now the adipose tissue. Adipose tissue, or it is also known as fatty tissue, it is a type of connective tissue which is mainly consisted of fat cells. Fat cells are also known as adipose cells, or it is also known as adipocytes. And what is their special function? They can store the large globules of fat within a structural network of fibers. Here what you are observing, adipocytes are there, and this is the structural network of fibers. So in between it, these cells will be enlarging its size due to the absorption or storage of fat in it. The fat they store, the fat stored in the adipose tissue comes from the dietary fats, or it is produced sometimes in our body. So more fat you will take in your diet, adipose tissue will store more fat and you may become obese. Sometimes fat is also produced in our body. Then what is the location of adipose tissue? It is present under the skin. It is present around the kidneys and it is present around the eyeball. Okay, it is present under the skin, like in the areolar tissue structure you have seen. It is present around the kidney because there is no skeletal support or surrounding around the skin. So that is why this adipose tissue will be acting as the shock absorbing cushion for the kidney. Okay, in the same manner it is present around the eyeball. So eye is a very soft and delicate organ. These two are soft and delicate organ, and when it is surrounding the soft and delicate organ, it acts as a shock absorbing cushion and protects such organ from the mechanical injuries. Okay, it acts as insulator. What does it mean? Insulator, it means any substance which will not allow the heat to pass through it. So below the skin we have the areolar tissue and the adipose tissue. So this tissue will be acting as insulator, and when this tissue is acting as insulator, it will not allow the internal heat of the body to be lost in the atmosphere, as well as the atmospheric high heat to enter inside our body. Okay, so what happens in summers, the temperature outside the body is high, so the heat should move from higher temperature towards the lower temperature, higher temperature towards the lower temperature, and your body temperature should rise, but it is not happening because of the presence of layer of adipose tissue in under the skin, which acts as insulator. In the same manner, in winters the temperature of body is high as compared to the temperature in the surrounding. So the body heat must be lost in the atmosphere, but again this is not done because of the presence of adipose tissue, which acts as insulator. So this is the structure of adipose tissue. Cytoplasm is there, nucleus is there, this is the adipocyte, this is the empty adipocyte, and here it is filled with fat. So this is the filled adipocytes, or adipocytes filled with fat. Blood vessels, yellow fibers, fat globules are there, fine white fibers is there, matrix is there, whatever intercellular space is there, it is filled with a fluid known as matrix. Then next we have to discuss about the fibrous connective tissue, and fibrous connective tissue is composed of parallel bundles of fibers. This is what, parallel bundles of fibers, and it is found in the dermis, tendons, ligaments, and it is referred to be as dense connective tissue. Before these two, adipose tissue and the areolar tissue is the loose connective tissue, and fibrous connective tissue is the dense connective tissue. Okay, there are two basic examples of fibrous connective tissue, that is tendon and ligament. So how you will remember, on the basis of location and function, the two differences asked between the tendons and ligaments. So tendons is present between the bones and muscles. Okay, and this ligament is found between the bones at the joints. Its function will be that it will connect the bones with the muscles, and ligaments function is that it connects the bones with the other bone at the joint. Okay, then on the basis of the elasticity, what is the difference? Ligament is elastic, that is why you are able to move the bones at the joints, whereas tendons are non-elastic. Okay, so these three basic difference you must remember. So tendons attaches bone to muscle, ligaments attaches bone to bone. Then tendons are non-elastic, sturdy, it means non-elastic, ligaments are elastic. They anchor the muscles with the bones, and they are strong, which attaches one bone with the other bone. So only this much, or whatever we have done, these three points you should remember. So this is all for today. Thank you everyone.